TNS earthing arrangement. Terra, neutral are separate. The supply authorities provide us with a separate protective earth and a separate neutral conductor into the installation. If this is what it looks like in a single phase domestic dwelling, how will it look in images shown to us for our exams? The left-hand side of this drawing shows the supply authority's cable with a separate line conductor, a separate neutral conductor, and a separate protective earth conductor coming into our installation. This is the cable we can physically see in the bottom of the cutout. This cable often comes to installations underground, but can also come overhead. This drawing also only shows one of the three star connected windings on the supply authority's side, as well as the centre tap point to earth. The supply authorities will provide the metering equipment and the cutout fuse sized 100, 80 or 60 amps for a single phase installation. The supply authority's protective earth will be either lead or steel. The installation showed on the right hand side could be a lot shorter in length than the supply authority's cable, comprising of a line, a neutral and a CPC conductor within circuit. As with the supply authority side, we have a separate line, neutral and CPC in circuit. The fuse for this circuit will not be 100 amps, but considerably less, maybe 20 amps, and would be located within the distribution board itself. The external earth fault loop impedance of the supply authority's cable is a maximum of 0.8 ohms for a TNS earthing arrangement. Measurement of external earth fault loop impedance is covered in two of my other video presentations. So to recap, where the supply authority brings in a separate line, neutral and protective earth conductor into the installation earthing arrangement is TNS.